Now, this is Tuesday, November, December 1, 2005. Now, just now you saw the video, the rabbit, the guinea pig had overgrown front teeth, the incisors. But if as a vet, you would think that just cut off the front teeth would be okay. Then the guinea pig will be able to eat. But actually, you are wrong. So now we give some anesthetic. I will show you the molar spur. Molar spur, and this molar spur, turn this side, and you can see there's something sharp curling downwards. This is the molar spur. This molar spur is from the right lower molars. So if you don't clip the molar spurs, then this guinea pig will not be able to eat properly. So now we just open up first to see. I open this side to check carefully the teeth. Now this one is okay, this side. We check both sides. And to check properly, you need anesthetic. So now what I do, I pour the tongue, and definitely you can see the molar spur on the right lower teeth. This is the molar spur there, this one. I point it here. This is the forceps, this is the molar spur of the right lower one, right lower molar. And I need to clip it short, otherwise it'd be hard for the guinea pig to grind. Now we check further. The upper one is okay. This upper one okay. And then we check this side as well. The left side, upper and lower. Okay, now we put back some anesthetic and then I will cut the molar spur. So the experience of this is that if you just cut the front teeth, then you'll find that if you never check the molars, then the guinea pig might not eat again. And that's because you can't grind the pellets. So actually for guinea pigs and rabbits, you have to check both. Actually, you cannot check one only. Although most time we check in the rabbit, we just check the front only. Or even chinchillas. Yesterday, check the anesthetic. You must go under gas anesthetic to check. Okay, now I'm going to clip already. Okay.